Yeah, my name's Lauren, welcome to Kids Books. Today we're going to talk about some authors I'm about to stan. Sure, this is content now. As with all of my reading, there is quite a mix of genres, quite a mix of authors in this pile of books that we're going to be talking about today. Some of these authors I have read one book by, some of them I've read two or three, some of them I have never read anything at all, but I get the vibe. The pre-stan moment has already been and gone. I think we're going to go roughly by genre. So the first person I'd like to talk about is Neil Schusterman, author of the Scythe Trilogy, Arc of a Scythe Trilogy series. It goes by many names. He has a really down-to-earth writing style. It's kind of strips back loads of frills and unearths this really pure, really quite dry and caustic sense of humour, and also the action sequences in his writing. Incredible. He manages to drive this really heavy plot without sacrificing us getting to know these characters, or without feeling like the writing doesn't have to be good because the plot's good. Like, it's just so fast paced and so well done, and every word matters and every word drives the plot forward. This is the series of Neil's that has kind of got big on BookTube recently. He does have a couple of other series that I am going to try out, but in the meantime I need to finish up this series. I am about a quarter of the way through the next one in the series, which is Thunderhead, and then it finishes up with The Tall. Not small boys, but I read them as if they are. And to be honest, I just want to keep an eye on Neil Schusterman. I want to know what he's coming out with next, what he's up to, how his day has been. Sticking with fantasy, this is one of the authors who I've read quite a few books by, actually, but I've never really considered myself a stan until now. It's V.E. Schwab. I recently read Country of Light, which is the end of the Shades of Magic series, which is hugely popular on BookTube, and I can totally understand why. Again, the plot is just so fast. But where she differs from Neil Schusterman is that she does keep a lot of this detail that really builds out a very intricate world. I feel like maybe the world building isn't as intricate in this because it's much closer to our everyday life. It's our society with a few tweaks. This, you don't just get one new world, you have three new worlds. And you know, for grace will pop into the world, you know. I am never a big fan of romance in fiction, and did someone say slow burn? Did someone say yearning? Did someone say gay rights quietly in the corner? They did. So I read this series by V.E. Schwab. I've also read the first in her ghosty series that I've totally forgotten the name of. City of Bones was the name of the first book. I read that last year or the year before, and it was middle grade, so it wasn't as good, but it was one of the best middle grades I've ever read. Years and years ago, I did read one of hers that I wasn't thrilled about. It was the first book in the Dark Duet duology, which I thought was just a bit crap, which is why it took me so long to finish these. But now that I've seen what she can do when her whole heart and mind is in something, we've got a stan. And I also have another one of her whole series on my shelf ready to go. So another sci-fi, fantasy, dystopian author. I'm going to go with one of the ones I haven't read much of yet. I am 5 pages into the 5th season by N.K. Jemisin. Maybe not 5 pages, maybe a little bit more than that. But the pre-stan is starting, it's bubbling. Just the concept, the world building, the family relationships, the second person mastery. Taking risks out there, pushing boundaries that no one else has even considered to exist yet. If I end up hating this book, I'm going to be really annoyed, because so far I absolutely love it. There are going to be 3 books, or maybe there are already 3 books in the Broken Earth series out already. She also has a couple of other series, one called the Inheritance Trilogy, which I had always heard people talking about and assumed they meant The Inheritance Cycle by Christopher Pellini, the Dragon series. Your girl is dumb. And she also has one listed that I've never heard of. The Dreamblood series. I had heard of her short story collection, How Long Till Black Future Month, which is just a stunning looking collection of short stories, quite frankly. I'm never keen on short stories, which is why I haven't picked it up yet. If I read this whole series, and I do indeed stan, then we shall be getting the short story collection. Let's have a little shift of pace right now. Let's slip into some translated authors that I am about to stan. This year, I think I've read a majority of translated authors, so that means the majority of the things I've read have been Japanese. And this is no exception to that trend. So when it first came out, I read Convenience Store Woman by Sayaka Murata, which every time I hear my own accent say that name, it's the Geordiest thing I've ever said. Sayaka Murata? This was hugely, hugely hyped the year it came out. It was in every shop window, every blog, every BookTube video, everyone read Convenience Store Woman. And it was a story of a young woman who lots of people who were neurodivergent related to, lots of people who were asexual related to. There was no kind of on the page representation, but she kind of spoke to a lot of us in the community. And it's all about how she kind of shuns the expectations of her life in Japan and is quite content working a little job at a convenience store. I read it, I stand it, and I was like, let's put it away. Let's lend it to everyone we know. So it kind of gets a bit gross and sticky. But I don't want to get rid of it because it's signed. But the longer I hold it, the ickier I feel, so I'm just gonna... Then Jessie was in Waterstones and one of the booksellers was like, hey, you look like the kind of bitch that enjoys Sayaka Murata. And Jessie was like, why in fact do we do? Why would you ring this up? And it was the day before the book came out, but they had it on the shelf. And she was like, come and look at this. And provided to us Murata's new book called Earthlings. Jessie read it this morning, and it turns out it's very gory, very weird, very different from Convenience Store Woman. But Jessie said like the tone was kind of the same, and that's what I'm here to stan. Can't find Earthlings, I don't know where Jessie has put it, but I'll put a picture in the video because it's beautiful and I am obsessed. Another bitch in translation, as I'm sure they will be really, really glad to be referred to as, that I read recently and fell in love with was Yoko Ogawa, who wrote The Housekeeper and The Professor. I've talked about this book so much on this channel recently that I'm not going to give you the synopsis again, and it's a Japanese classic anyway, it's fairly well known. You might also recognise the name Yoko Ogawa because she wrote The Memory Police, which kind of was tipped to do very well this year. I've heard that people who love this hate The Memory Police and vice versa, which is kind of worrying. But this brought me so much peace and just so much catharsis and relaxation in the middle of a pandemic that I was like, you know what? If she can hit it out of the park once, I'm sure she can do it again. So I'm going to try and pick up The Memory Police soon, and I'm also going to do a bit more of a deep dive and see if any of her other works have been translated, because it's really only these two that ever get talked about and I'd like to learn a little bit more. Another writer whose works I have not technically read, but I'm so obsessed with her as a person, I can't see any way that I will not stan her works, and that is Ms. Bernadine Evaristo of Man Book of Fame, for all the wrong reasons. So after the great 2019 Man Booker debacle incident, I decided I was going to follow Bernadine on Twitter, and she's an absolute fucking legend, quite frankly. So I was like, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to grab a couple of her books next time I'm in a bookshop and I don't have an idea of exactly what I'm going to be there for. I'm just going to grab some of her stuff, because everyone in the world has read it after the Man Booker incident, and following kind of the BLM, let me show you how diverse my June book haul is, and obviously fantastic reviews. And I also found out that Girl, Woman, Other contains non-binary characters, which is something we love to see. Also, you might be like, okay, she's got loads of books. why did you pick up, obviously you were going to pick up Girl, Woman, Another. Why The Emperor's Bib? Because it is the one I've heard the least about on BookTube. And because apparently it's not contemporary queer women's issues good shit. It's a historical novel set in ancient Rome. The range this woman has, unparalleled. What am I talking about? I have read Bernadine Evaristo. I read Mr. Loverman by Bernadine Evaristo last month. Maybe I didn't put it on my wrap-up. Maybe that's why I forgot that I'd read it. And I'll tell you why I forgot I read it, because I didn't buy the physical book. I bought the audiobook on Audible. Yes, I know Audible's evil. I'm working on it. If I don't own the book, if I can't see it, I will forget. And that's like no tea, no shade on these authors. That's just me. So Mr. Loverman was I loved it so much. It was two gay men from Antigua in their 60s, in love, dealing with kind of familial and religious expectations, cultural expectations, and chronicling basically how they'd secretly been in this relationship since they were 14. And old people in love is not something we get to see enough in fiction. Oh, it was just so funny and so warm and so devastating at the same time that we already stand. It's inevitable. Then we get to the bitch in question. The bitch who made me make this video. Because in the 90s she was like, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna write about some lesbians in Victorian England and I'm gonna absolutely destroy them. And then, if you're lucky, I might give them a happy ending. And the bitch in question, Sarah Waters. can you believe it took me 4 years of being out of the closet to pick up a Sarah Waters book? Like, my bi flatmate in uni was always like, Lauren, Ms. Waters is the one. And I was like, oh, such chunky books, and like, all this internalized lesbophobia is real. To the point where I still don't feel like I can say lesbian, I have to say sapphic instead, but that's something for my therapist to worry about, not you. Yeah. I read this last month, became obsessed. Like, there were things about it that were not great because it was a first novel. Like, some of the bits were a little bit bloated, which Sarah Waters has herself said that she would happily cut down on some of those parts. But the characters, incredible. Their motivations, nuanced. The story of a working class girl going to London and finding it a bit tricky. Can't relate. There was like a really definite moment where I was about 100 pages off finishing this book, and I was messaging Michael, and I was just like, I'm about to stan Sarah Waters, aren't I? And he's just like, yeah, you got no chance. No chance of escape. And we were correct. I can't stop thinking about this book. So much so that in the two bookshops I've been to since I came out of lockdown, two new Sarah Waters books. I picked up The Fingersmith, which, get your minds out of the gutter, is about a thief. You thought it was a different kind of fingersmithing, didn't you? Let's be real, that's going to be in there. Like, it's lesbian thieves, of course. I'm really hoping this is like Oliver, but Fagin is a dyke. Like, Fagin and Nancy are lesbians. If that's not what this is, I don't even care. because I'm going to stan anyway. What I'm really, really going to stan, tell me what you stan and what you really, really stan. Affinity. You're not even ready. It's about ghosts. It's about mediums and psychics and ghosts in London, in lesbian Victorian London with ghosts. Really hoping it's not kinky. Because, like, this pretty much reached my level of being able to read a sex scene without, like, crying or becoming visibly embarrassed. But I expected it, so I read it all in the house. Sarah Waters can't catch me out. Well, she can, but... this is straight on my October TBR. If you think this isn't what I'm reading for Halloween, you're crazy. Another author I've never read anything by is Eliza Clarke. Jessie read this recently, Boy Parts. It has been highly recommended by my good friend Amy. Apparently it's a bit dark compared to what I normally read, and maybe even a little bit sexier than I normally read. So you might be like, Lauren, those are all the things you hate the most. It's a contemporary book with sex and gore. Why are you gonna stan it? Because she's northern, right? Because it's set in Newcastle, and because instead of saying mum or mum, she says ma'am. And everyone knows if you say ma'am, you're in a club, the Northern Solidarity Club. The Welsh, people from Liverpool, people from Manchester, the Scots, the Irish, the Geordies. If you say ma'am, you're in the club. So these are some of the authors I am about to stan. If you have any recommendations of books by these authors or books similar to these authors, please, please let me know, because yes, I've doubled the size of my TBR since lockdown began. Yes, I've read hardly anything. No, I won't be shamed. And also let me know if there's any authors you are about to stan, because it's always nice to share. Bye.